Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, we're going to look into one of the interesting applications of pattern recognition neural network. So what we are going to do is to create a neural network to which we can feed the handwritten numbers images, and then the network we have created will predict which number it is. You will see that it is easily attainable by using the concepts that we have already learned. So in this case, I am using the MNSIT Dataset, which you can easily find by typing in Google. So the procedure which we are going to follow is, first we are creating the autoencoder for compressing the images, which is a 28 by 28 pixels in size, to a lower dimension size. So we are using two autoencoders. So autoencoder 1 will compress the image from 28 into 28, that is 784 inputs to 400 inputs. And then we are going to use that 400 to be fed in the next autoencoder, which will further compress it to 100 inputs. And then we can make the use of pattern recognition neural network, that is PatternNet, and train the network in a supervised manner. After that, we will see the confusion matrix to check the accuracy of the network created. One of the interesting and more advanced application that can be used if the dataset is available is, instead of inputting the handwritten digits, we can input the hand gestures. And as a label, we can create the approximate meanings of that gesture. So by making the use of time series neural network, the pattern recognition neural network, and the autoencoders, we can create a network that can help us understanding the sign language. So I have already written the code. Let's look into the code line by line. So first I will load the MNSIT dataset using this command. Then the dataset structure will be imported in the workspace, which will contain the training and the test images separately. So let's run this section. So after running this section, we see that a dataset structure is imported in the workspace. Click on it. As you can see, the dataset contains three fields, that is train, images, test images, and the mapping. So the train images will contain the images that we will be using for training. And there are 240,000 images available. And for each image, that is each column will represent an image. So each column has a number of rows of 784 that will be representing a 28 into 28 pixel image. And the corresponding label is mentioned in the labels. So the first image is image 8. Similarly, the second image, that is the second number, is number 9, and so on. Similar is the case for test field also. We see that the labels we have actually tells us which number it is. But as we remember from our previous videos, that we require hot encoded matrix as the target. So this is what we are doing in the next lines. So for the training dataset that we have, we are making a target matrix, or target 1, that is hot encoded matrix. So this is the simple for loop and the if statement. After that, we are doing the same thing to the test dataset, converting it to the double data type, and then hot encoding the labels it has. After that, we are plotting the first 20 images using simple for loop and the image show command. Note that we have used the reshape because in the input image matrix, each column represents an image. So we reshape that to a 28 by 28 pixel so that we can finally use the image show on that. After that, we are using the default random number generator. This is done because finally what we will do is combine all the neural networks that we have created. So the two autoencoders and one pattern net that we will be creating will be stacked or combined together. So it makes sense to have the same random number generation for each of these neural networks. After that, we have our first autoencoder. So this is trained in the similar way like discussed in the previous videos. So give the hidden size of 400 and then use the train autoencoder by supplying the input, the hidden size, and the other parameters. We use the default parameters supplied by the MATLAB. Then we can use the view autoencoder. After that, we are getting the features from this autoencoder by using the encode command. This will give us the compressed form of the image that we have inputted. So we are using 400 neurons. So basically, feature 1 will represent the same images but in 400 neurons instead of 784 neurons. After that, we are plotting the new images that are created using this autoencoder to get a comparison between the actual image and the reshaped image or the resized image. Then we use a second autoencoder and we provide it with the hidden size of 100, and using the same command, that is train autoencoder, we train that network. In this command, we are looking into how our input image features will look like once they are compressed by the second autoencoder. After that, we are either creating a softmax layer or a pattern recognition neural network. So as you may recall, in case of pattern net, we have softmax layer as the output. So we can either supply just the softmax layer and train it in a supervised manner, or we can also provide a hidden layer. So basically, if we provide a hidden layer, we will be using a pattern net. If you use soft net, the time taken for the whole training will be comparatively less, but accuracy will also reduce a little bit. But to increase the accuracy, even though that time will be increasing, we will use the pattern net. So we supply the training function at train SCG. Hidden layer size we will keep it as 10. In the usual manner, we will create a pattern net and train it. We are using the performance function of cross entropy. So what we have done till now is created two autoencoders for compressing the image from high number of inputs to a small number of inputs, and then feeding these small number of inputs into the pattern net for training in a supervised manner. After that, we use the stack command to combine these three neural networks that we have created. And then we can get the output from the stack network, which we are calling DeepNet, and then plot the confusion matrix. Note that we have kept the test ratio as 0 because for testing our network, we already have the test dataset available in our MNSIT dataset. So we just use that test dataset and its corresponding labels. So we provide the test in the DeepNet to get the output as Y, and then plot the confusion matrix between the test labels, which are hot encoded, and the output Y. If the accuracy of the network is not good, we can retrain the whole network. So DeepNet we have created will act as just as one network, and then we use a simple train command by providing it with the input and the target one as we usually do in our supervised learning, and then get the output and then plot the confusion. So let's run this code. Since this code involves 4 trainings, so it will take a little bit time to get completed. So after all the training is completed, this is what our neural network will look like. So in this we have the first encoder, then second encoder, and then this is the pattern net. And we are supplying with the 784 inputs, which get reduced to 400 in the first encoder, and then 200 in the second encoder, and finally to the output of 10, which are basically the labels of the numbers. These are the same plots for the pattern recognition neural network. So let's see the different plots that we have generated. These are the actual images that we have available from our MNIST dataset. So these are the first 20 images that I plotted. This represents the images that have been compressed by using the autoencoder 1. So as you can see, these are a little bit blurred. So figure 3 basically represents how the features of our input images are stored within the hidden layer of the second autoencoder. Then this is the image of the first autoencoder. This is the image of the second autoencoder. So it compresses from 400 to 100 neurons. And this is the image of the pattern recognition neural network. So without training the stack neural network, the accuracy which we obtain is 37.8%, which is very low. So what we do is retrain the network that we have created. And as we can see, the accuracy improves to 96%. Which is very good as compared to the last time. So this is how we create a deep network for classifying the input images. You may be thinking that why we use autoencoders, why not just simply supply the input images directly to the pattern recognition neural network. So if we would have supplied 784 inputs with let's say 10,000 samples, the time taken for simulating such will be very very high. Or it may be possible that you are computer may not be able to perform such high level of calculations, and right after clicking the run option, your software may stop or not respond. So that's why we are using the autoencoders and then supplying the reduced number of inputs to the pattern recognition neural network. So that's it everyone. This is it for this video. Hope you like it. And please like, subscribe and share. And thanks for watching.